We are live on the floor of the 2014 Global Real Estate Summit in Chicago, and I'm here with Mike Fascitelli, who's the owner of MDF Capital, who just participated on a panel titled Responding to the New Drivers of Real Estate. Now, Mike, we've been hearing a lot this morning about change, innovation, and uncertainty. But before we launch into those issues, tell me a little bit about MDF Capital. What's your focus and strategy right now in the market?
I just set up my own firm to look at investment opportunities, particularly in real estate, but even in some private equity. Smaller companies and focused on New York City because that's the market I know best. I've looked at some other markets and looking at some value-added, not core, but value-added development, redevelopment opportunities.
Okay. Now, given the inevitable changes on the horizon that are driven largely by technology and demographics, we've been hearing a lot about this morning, and the shifting needs of users. That's been a big focus so far, that the needs of the users are changing, not only in the office market, but in residential, multifamily, et cetera. Where do you see the opportunity today?
I think the opportunity for most people, if you're smaller, like I am now, having run a big company like Vonato, is in being very focused and specific in an area that you might be coming up in either office or retail or apartments. Because if you go into the established areas with the established product, you can't compete against the cost of capital. So if you take a little bit of a twist and tape capitalize on people wanting new space or different configurations, and you take a building and you have it maybe in a little less location, but you can give the tenants what they want and you can attract the tenant, both retail or office or even residential or all the above, and making a mixed-use project. So I'm looking for, I think what others are, a little bit niche.
Okay. Now, you mentioned, I thought this was fascinating during the panel, that you had spent the day recently in an open office space.
Right.
I know this is an emerging trend. There's companies like WeWork and Liquid Space and others that are doing
this. There's quite a few in that space.
Yes. What impact do you think these types of companies are going to have in the office market moving forward? Do you think it's going to be significant? Do you think it's going to be building up over time? What do you think it's going to look like 10 years from now?
I don't think as a total square foot user, they're going to have huge impact. But I do think they've had incremental impact. Certainly they were the higher growing users during this recession and coming out of the recession. I think they're also going to have a high impact on other people emulating the kind of things they're doing
right.
But not necessarily in rented open space, but their own space. So the kind of configurations and environment they're building, I think is going to be taken into a lot more spaces than the actual ones that they're renting for that.
Right.
So. They'll have both. They'll take incremental square feet, and more people will do it. But as you get bigger, it's still quite expensive to do if you get any kind of size. So I think it'll just be the kind of environment people create when they lease their own space directly.
Sure. Okay. Now, in DLA Piper's 2014 State of the Market survey, we found that 89% of executives told us that they feel very bullish about the 12-month outlook for the commercial real estate market. Now, that's the highest it's ever been in the 10 years that we've been doing the study. Now, Sam Zell told us this morning that he thinks that optimism is unjustified. What's your take on the current level of optimism?
It scares the shit out of me. I think, you know, if you've been in the business a long time, like Sam has and me, although Sam has been in longer, and you see Roy's presentation, it looks like everything is very frothy, or maybe the ebullience is a little overheated. It looks feels like more like, and Steve Roth said, maybe it's the fifth inning, but it's not the eighth or ninth inning. It may be the fifth or sixth inning, but it's a low scoring game, and you're ahead by a very narrow margin. You have to really worry. I think if you're investing your own money, it's a time to be cautious and very specific. It's a relative game right now, not an absolute game. The absolutes look kind of tough, but on a relative basis, real estate looks still pretty good.
Okay. Again, that was Mike Fascitelli of MDF Capital. Mike, thank you.
Thanks, Sean. Thank you.